Hello, welcome to our LVDS educational series with Texas Instruments. My name is Charlie Tsai. In this video, I'll dive deeper into the advantages of LVDS and explain how some of these advantages are achieved. In this section, I'm going to cover data rate and distance, low power consumption, noise immunity, minimal EMI, and some other additional benefits from TI LVDS devices. First, let's start with data rate and distance. LVDS can achieve more than 1 gigabit per second. This data rate can be maintained over a long distance. Generally, data rate versus distance can be represented by this diagram. This diagram shows a comparison between LVDS and m-lvds. m-lvds is a variant of LVDS technology, and we'll cover this topic in later series.
RS-485 and RS-422 are both differential signaling standards. Compared to LVDS, they can support cables that's more than 100 meters long. However, they can only run up to 35 megabits per second. This is a major drawback nowadays when we are pushing for higher and higher data rates.
Keep in mind that there are many factors affecting the performance. This diagram shown here is a comparison between standards only. The reason LVDS can achieve this data rate is because of its low output voltage swing, which results in a fast switching slope. Let's compare LVDS to RS-422, another standard differential signaling protocol. RS-422 has a voltage swing of 2 volts, but LVDS only has 350 millivolt voltage swing. With a lower voltage swing, it only takes about 0.8 nanoseconds for LVDS to switch from low to high or high to low. This low voltage swing offers an added benefit of reduced power consumption. When talking about power, we can categorize it into power dissipated by the device and power dissipated on the load. Power dissipation on the load is very simple. The formula is voltage times current, or voltage squared divided by the load resistance. Now we should all know that the load is 100 ohm, and the voltage across the load is 350 millivolts. So power consumption is only 1.225 milliwatts. It is extremely low compared to other standards. In fact, it is one of the lowest among differential signaling methods, as you can see from this chart. When talking about power consumption by the device, we need to bring a few more components into the equation. Let's use a LVDS driver, DS90LV011A, as an example. To get typical power consumption in standby mode, we need the typical voltage and the typical current draw. These two tables are taken straight from DS90LV011A datasheet. The typical supply voltage VDD is 3.3 volts, and the typical supply current IDD is 7 milliamp. In standby mode, the power consumption by the device is 23.1 milliwatts. To get the total power consumption by the device, we also need to consider active mode. In active mode, we would need to use this formula, and we already know all these variables. The device would consume additional 10.325 milliwatts in active mode. So the total current consumption for DS90LV011A is 33.425 milliwatts. This power draw is one magnitude lower than typical RS-422, RS-485, or Ethernet chipsets. Another great benefit of LVDS technology is the high noise immunity. Typically, the differential pair connecting LVDS driver and receiver is closely coupled. When external noise is present in the environment, both wires will receive nearly equal amount of noise. Since the receiver only cares about the voltage potential between the two wires, the external noise will be canceled out. This is a very important advantage over single-ended technology. This property enables LVDS to have a very high signal-to-noise ratios, and is one of the reasons why LVDS technology is so robust. If the application uses single-ended technology, any external noise will get coupled on the wire, and this noise will affect the signal voltage on the line, which ultimately introduces more data errors. As a differential circuit, LVDS driver and receiver radiates substantially less electromagnetic wave and less noise to the environment than single-ended circuit. This is a cross-section view of differential pair versus single-ended wire. On the left, complementary current runs in the pair of wires. Both lines will generate magnetic fields, but in the opposite direction. In turn, the magnetic field cancels each other. On the right side, since current only goes in one direction, the magnetic field generated will emit to the environment freely. In addition, due to lower signal amplitudes, the potential for emission of noise is lower as well. Now I have talked about some of the standard LVDS benefits. In addition to these, Texas Instruments has developed a series of LVDS devices that offers additional benefits. LVDS standard defines a common mode input range of 0 to 2.4 volts. However, in harsh environment or over long distance, oftentimes this range may not be sufficient. Texas Instruments developed devices that have about 3 times the standard input voltage range, from negative 4 volts to 5 volts. This is a huge advantage over standard LVDS driver and receiver. These devices, such as SN65 LVDS33, should be considered when the end application is used in harsh environments. TI also offers LVDT receivers, which has integrated resistor. This type of LVDS receiver have added the benefit of saving external resistors, resulting into saving board space, device count, and assembly effort. TI offers a wide range of LVDS driver and receivers that's suitable for different applications. For full portfolio, please go visit ti.com/LVDS. Thank you for watching this video.